keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gonna act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
You can fold or you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch you hate, watch them lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight. Yeah, I been grinding since I'm young and they told me my timing was coming. I been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money. I'm out in LA where it's sunny. I been eating since I'm young and since we ain't have food in our tummy. The life we was living ain't funny, but you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother, I'll show you. Way better than I can tell you. The type of dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it all on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gonna act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
Every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'ma say. Got a new press, those and the J's, I don't really got a new press. Watch where they don't take time. I pull up on a hop if it's up too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock.
I done made it about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Just do it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. Just do it. All the more on my wrist, going stupid. Just do it. Tryna put them on, but they never. Like, don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken. That tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep it racking my sauce.
BA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerged from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The shadow window starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports.
And this will make it into the end zone.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And up past the 35, a very good return, but a penalty down. That may negate all the good work.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
On play action, now Brady. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared, but I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later. But defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and trying not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
And oh my goodness, what a catch at the 6. He got 29 yards that time. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to...
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Got to laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha, that was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
Incompletion on first down leads to a 2nd and 10. Throwing again, Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Open man is Godwin. It's complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on 3rd. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. So a good run by Fournette. Now another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. Three yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
33-yard line.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Looking downfield for Godwin. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Number 14, Chris Godwin.
Chris Godwin. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Ryan Succop set to kick off.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today. So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore. And that'll make it third down.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. And that is incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a 3 and out, and giving the ball back to their offense.
This is fielded at the 27. It'll be a 40-yard punt, 8 on the return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense.
At their own 35-yard line.
The Bucs' offense set to begin their next possession. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
Rasul Douglas there to get him down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. From the shotgun, it's a give to McCord. Get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a first down on a gain of 10. It's a good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to run.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
Down at the 43-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup. Brings up 2nd and 2.
On 2nd down, here's Fournette. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
First down carry by Jones.
Ronald Jones.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
At the 38-yard line. A gain of 4. It's now second and six.
On second down, it's Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give them 14 on that one, and a first down.
A gain of 14. First down, Buccaneers.
7-7, our score after one.
Score tied 7-7.
They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Now Leonard Fournette. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and it'll be third down. Throw is Brady. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Read it well and it's picked. And a short return to the 6 yard line. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range. But boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. And Mahomes is going to go down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on, come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And 2 picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw 4 or 5 picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a 2nd and 10.
Tie me up in chains, I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables, yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes while you walk your pugs in a town you could rate where there ain't no love.
Where do I go? Where am I alone? Not on the phone. Where am I on my own? They don't know my name.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault, and that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. The third-year man from USC, this is Ronald Jones. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Second and six.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30.
A two-yard gain on the play.
And here's Brady. And that will be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. Back deep for the Panthers, DJ Moore. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. It's a 39-yard punt, three on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10.
At their own 32-yard line.
The 32 now. Here's first and 10.
Set the tone, defense. Set the tone, defense. Let's go.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Being chased out left. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. Unable to corral him. He fights through. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A big play there. The catch and run, 66 yards. From the two, here's first and goal. Mahomes quickly complete out wide. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. DJ Moore. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Buccaneers, nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Bucs take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain there of 30 big ones. They went with the nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then, you take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you take a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
You got four.
keep on the ground with Jones. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Big Derrick Brown making the stop.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Second and seven. Brady, he'll have a first down inside the 10. This is caught. Gronkowski. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Gronk's first catch. Good for a first down. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about three. Second and goal from the 1. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Touchdown. Leonard Fournette, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And he puts it through.
That ties the game at 7. Ryan Succop set to kick off.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
23 yards, the final tally.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
The first carry for the shifty Tariq Cohen. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From midfield now on second down, Mahomes. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And now last drive so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of. But so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action. Now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But, you know, there was a big-time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad. He would have kissed it on the ground.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. Able to fall on it, but look where they recovered it. That's a big loss.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage. But I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Looking downfield for Godwin. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And a big game that time. He's out of bounds. And what will be the final play of this first quarter? Through one quarter, 14-7 our score.
Panthers 14, Buccaneers 7.
line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now Mahomes. Eluding the pressure right. And his pass incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off. He's at the 50, the 30, the 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Good job over there, baby.
Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
Extra point up and good by Succa. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just...
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Levante David. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Intercepted.
That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
The throw there by Brady, intended for Gronkowski, but incomplete. He was looking for Gronk that time, but it's going to be second down. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it, and he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
It's another OSCE, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. OSCE tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the OSCE, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
And this one is incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the intended target, and it's second down.
It's now
an incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
45 to Mike. Hey, pick your game up. 45, Mike. 45. Here we go. Let's attack, attack. Let's bring it. Attack.
Throwing now is Mahomes. Flush to his right. Winds up. And this is caught at the 20. And down to the 20, he'll go before heading out of bounds. It's a gain of 34. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. And he's got it complete to Anderson. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 12 more yards there and another first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
The former Gamecock here, this is Mike Davis. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long 3rd and goal. A big play forthcoming. Here's 3rd and goal. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Lavonte David. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Tackle made by Kaywan Short.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running play. I'm actually a little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. The throw on second down by Brady is incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Bucs are going to take the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in big sky country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Mahomes will try again on second down. He's going to look deep for more. And that's caught inside the 30. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Panthers, first down. First and 10 at the 15.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Mahomes to throw once more. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
Buying time to his left. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down. But the passing game right now for them, not overly impressive. Last week he hit on right at 50%. This week he's under 50%.
And it's not just on him. Protection, a few breakdowns along the way that's made him get off the spot. Receivers not getting their way open downfield. The coverage has been awfully tight. They've got to all get together and find ways to make this passing game get in gear.
Accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Joey Sly on now for the Panthers. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And this one is right through. And that'll bring him back within four. So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
Yeah, things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to the goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
16 yards.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Brady now to throw. Looking downfield for Godwin. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A big pickup of 38.
How about the first half he's putting together? Well over 100 yards already with that last catch. And to me, they'd be well served to keep looking his way. A number of big plays already in this one.
On the delay, Jones. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
On second and a yard, Brady. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third and short. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks.
And he's
going
to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and they will open their lead up to a touchdown at 24-17. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get three before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that, and we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, Well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Escaping the pressure right. He's going to look deep for more. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down. Mahomes now to throw. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down. It appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half, still down by that slim margin.
Yeah, and that's okay. You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they, on the sidelines, go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
First carry now for the backup, LeSean McCoy. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A gain of 13, it's a first down. A gain of a good run by Fournette. Now another first and 10. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, second down.
All runners count on their eyes to find the gaps and creases, to find open space. There was absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now he'll throw with Brady, and that is incomplete.
Brady certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
10 yards to go.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 15. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Panthers take over.
That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw or maybe the ball's tipped or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. They go play fake. Mahomes. He's going to look deep for more. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Second and 10 now, third quarter from Charlotte. He's going to look deep for more. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, 63 yards. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. And then he'll bang that one through.
That ties the game 24-24.
Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
DJ Logan on the return. The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. It's a gain of 35. The safeties were well back there, and he had a lot of room. Were they in the cover too?
Yeah, they were, and the safeties were back. You know, usually they're 12 to 15 yards off the line of scrimmage, somewhere around the hash mark for each of them. But what also happens if the linebackers dive into the line, if you block them initially,
he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Touchdown. Ronald Jones, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bucs are going to take the lead. And he's able to put it through.
Good. Makes the score Buccaneers 31, Panthers 24.
Now it's Ryan Succop after the touchdown to kick it away.
The Panthers take over first. At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, and you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Mahomes going to throw. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Intended for DJ Moore.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. He's got a man complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That goes for a gain of 31.
When they needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now Cohen. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
2nd and 11 now. Mahomes, he'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 14. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. From the red zone now, Mahomes. And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore. DJ Moore there to make the grab. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game.
That ties the game.
Point after, right down the middle. And that will tie our game here in the third. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Bucs take over 1st and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. So from Panther territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. And we're back now in Charlotte. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Fournette, a 1st down carry. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
That throw by Brady, incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And they're going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 26. Brady to Gronk, a familiar ring to that one, and it's a Buccaneers 1st down. Despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. 2nd down. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's 2nd and 13. Brady's throw there complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Complete to Rob Gronkowski.
Rob Gronkowski, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs are going to take the lead.
His kick is.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a seven-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. He's going to look deep for more. And that's caught inside the 30.
Prime time,
and
baby.
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, 75 yards. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And an important one that is, as we are all tied now early in this fourth quarter. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll drop to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 18. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
For the point after.
In a tie game, fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations the type of plays they like to run. Read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And can they regroup? That's the question. The pick six hurt, no doubt, but this is still a one-score game here. And now here is another interception. Cordray Tankersley with a pick. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. Six interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Again, he finds Moore. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
And he'll go right back to Moore, complete again. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. DJ Moore taking it in. And thanks to the interception, the Panthers offense cashes in with six. And they're able to up the lead by one more.
Makes the score Panthers 52. Buccaneers.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded near the back of the end zone.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Deion Buchanan. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers.
Touchdown.
And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
The extra point splits the uprights. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 21.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He fakes the give here and looks to throw. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And all the way down to the 26. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 49 yards. What a game for this offense and the 43-year-old QB Tom Brady. And hey, if they get points here, they can finally surpass his age on the scoreboard. He's going to take a shot for the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
It's now second and 10.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. To throw again. Brady, he sets up the screen to Jones. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That'll go as a loss of five. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. Now Brady again. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
It's a gain of eight.
That's certainly playing down a distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And this is going to be incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Panthers will get the football back.
Result of the play is a turnover.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And it's all but certain that this win streak is going to extend another week. Just another tremendous performance in this one. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. This defense, Charles, they have unraveled here in the fourth.
In a sense, it's like they're being pressed, like in a basketball game, and they just can't get the ball over half court. I mean, no matter what they do, they can't get off the field, they can't slow them down, they're just going up and down the field against them. Yeah, unraveling would be a perfect word for them.
Yellow! There's a wall there, right? How do you get out of the headache? How do you get out of the headache?